Firefighters have been an important part of the fundraising efforts for the Muscular Dystrophy Association for more than half a century. In fact, the well-known Fill the Boot campaign is a tradition that dates back to 1952, when a father in desperate need ran to International Association of Firefighters Union member George Graney's Fire Engine Company 1 in South Boston. IAFF Local 718 immediately rounded up 20 firefighters and set in motion a door-to-door canister drive that raised $5,000. Since then, firefighters across the nation have united to raise money to help kids everywhere and to fund efforts to treat and cure muscular dystrophy. The IAFF is the single largest sponsor of MDA. To date, the union has raised more than $607 million for MDA. The Virginia Beach Fire Department and Local 2924 is proud to be part of this effort, but there were challenges that limited our initial fundraising efforts.
We were unable to collect on street corners because of the panhandling ordinance in the city of Virginia Beach.
Many years ago, we used to be out in the streets collecting and everything, and then that became a problem because they allowed us to keep going out in the streets. They were having to let the football teams and the cheerleaders, and now you got 10, 11, 12-year-olds running out in the street. And I believe it was in Texas they had a couple fatalities, Texas, Florida. So the city put a stop to it, and I can't say that I blame them. You know, we don't want anybody to get hurt.
So we had to find a way to circumvent that, and we approached Chief Hutchison and senior staff.
BJ approached me and said, could we, you know, do it in the store, in the parking lots and different places like that, and then could we add, you know, an engine or a ladder, or, you know, keep them on duty, but could they be there to help out? And man, did it really work.
The greater presence having the fire trucks out there and the guys on duty in uniform has helped with the morale when we're out there doing this. It's also helped collect even more money.
What do they say, the proof's in the pudding, right? I mean, we collected, wasn't it right at like $30,000, a large increase as to what we had been collecting. So obviously there's nothing wrong with $30,000, but I certainly think we can improve on that.
We just need to get more volunteers out there off duty, whether it's you, your wife, your kids. It doesn't matter how many people are out there, if they're fire department or not. We can all be out there with the guys helping them collect money. And the more places we have, the more people that are out there volunteering, the more money we're going to collect.
The fire departments around the country are the MDA's number one fundraiser for a reason. Well, I mean, you think about it, you know, we're here to help, you know, the citizens and everybody of Virginia Beach. And this is just another way to make that outreach a little further. And they're getting closer to finding cures, and they're doing things now that wasn't possible, you know, 25, 30 years ago.
The more money we collect, the more kids' lives we improve.
My name is Emily. I'm 16 years old.
Emily has a form of muscular dystrophy called Charcot-Marie Tooth. CMT is the most commonly inherited peripheral nerve disorder, affecting about 1 in 2,500 people. CMT causes damage to the peripheral nerves, which carry signals from the brain and spinal cord to the muscles.
So I don't have any feeling from my knees down and my arms down. I fell into a really, really dark, deep hole, and I didn't really have anybody to help me out. My family were very, very helpful. But through the help of MDA, I went to one of the summer camps and absolutely changed my life.
Because it's this giant place where everybody's the same. It doesn't matter whether you're in a wheelchair with a breathing machine or you're like she is and has to have special shoes and special braces.
I got to learn that all the kids there, what I take for granted, they can't even do. They can't hug, they can't walk on their own, they can't use the bathroom by themselves, they can't cut their own food, and all that stuff I take for granted, which made me really open my eyes and realize that I'm not as bad off as I could be. MDA definitely really helped me realize that I'm not alone in my struggles that I face every day, and that I always have somebody who's looking after me or making sure I'm okay. And I appreciate it from the bottom of my heart that you guys go out there and fill the boot for us, because without it, I don't think I'd be standing here today talking to you guys about camp and everything that you guys do really, really helps. So thank you all very, very much for what you do.
I know how much you guys do for your community in general. And then on top of that, you add what you do for Fill the Boot. I know it's not a small task. I know you're out there in the heat. I know you've got trainings. I know you have a lot going on. And we truly appreciate it. But taking that positive energy and that positive attitude, especially for these parents that have to deal with stuff every day, hopefully that can motivate you a little bit.
Your efforts to Fill the Boot has an impact on these families even greater than you can imagine.
So honestly, it gives them hope. I mean, it's a future. It's advanced treatments. It's life beyond 12. It's life beyond 16. It's a chance for kids to use, you know, modern terminology, it's a chance for them to adult.
So the money that's going into these boots is producing real tangible results.
I mean, results that we'll see in the next 5 to 10 years. Some of them we're seeing now. So anytime the MDA and the firefighters get together and they hold a boot and they're helping a child, then they're superheroes to me.
And the Muscular Dystrophy Association has even employed technology to help you with your fundraising efforts. This year, if someone tells you they don't have cash on them, you can hand them a card with a phone number on it so they can text a donation to MDA. All they have to do is simply text BOOT52 to 71777. A link will appear in their text feed, and they click on that and follow the prompts to the website to make a secure online donation. They can do a $5, $10, $25, or choose a different dollar amount, more or less, than what is offered. They will get a receipt sent to their email. But remember, the best donation is cash in the boot. So let's get out there and fill the boot a little higher this year.